I'm reminded of the old mantra parents and teachers often tell children, you're not living up to your potential. Or how about this one? You're capable of so much more. So what in the world does that have to do with an LLC converter? Well, as I'm about to demonstrate, a lot. Before I do, let me set some context and cover three reasons why I think LLC converters are finding themselves utilized below their potential capabilities. First, these power supplies are used in applications with very demanding system level requirements. High efficiency, low cost, high reliability, in many ways, you really need to have it all. Second, this topology needs robust fault management. Before I worked with the LLC converters, I never heard of folks talking about the need for a ZCS avoidance scheme. I mean, in a lot of cases, zero current switching or ZCS is a good thing, right? Well, not for the LLC converter's primary side MOSFETs. In fact, for these fellas, it can mean an explosive end to a very short career. Now, I'm going to demonstrate a new LLC controller we have that solves these problems and show you how it's capable of taking a power supply from a popular commercial gaming system and transforming its already very good performance to something that is over the top awesome. Here is a power supply that has been removed from one of these systems. If I flip the board over, you can see some of the more sensitive control circuitry, and right here is the LLC resonant controller for the converter. In a few moments, I'm going to show you some performance data from this power supply using this controller. After that, I'm going to replace this controller with our new device. You can see here that we have surgically removed the existing controller and carefully wired in a small daughter board with our device on it. After we capture data from the original system, we'll repeat the tests with the new controller and show you just how much we were able to improve the performance of this already high-performing power supply. Okay, enough with that. Let's look at some data. First up is transient response. For the sake of comparison, we'll exercise the system under the largest possible transient. The yellow trace shows the output voltage, and the green trace shows the load current. In the original system, we have a 1-volt dip on the output. Now, this is not necessarily bad. Remember, this system works just fine. The issue is, we can do much better. In fact, when you look at these same conditions with our controller, we are 10 times better. Honestly, it's hard to even see the voltage movement on the output with our device. Now, just in case someone listening is thinking, so what? Let me comment on what this means at a more basic level. Number one, lower system cost. In fact, we have estimated in a typical LLC converter, our controller will allow you to achieve the same transient response with 20 to 25% less output capacitance. That can turn into a very tangible system level cost savings. Number two, increased system robustness. If you prefer not to change the output capacitor bank, you can just live with the added peace of mind that when this controller is managing the output, it is going to stay very tightly regulated under all conditions. Next, let's look at light load system efficiency. This plot shows that our controller has significantly increased the efficiency of the system by as much as 10%. This is of huge practical benefit for a couple of reasons. Number one, regulatory requirements are becoming more and more demanding by stipulating that systems like this need to be more and more efficient under these kinds of load conditions. So while the original system met its requirements, the modified system provides the manufacturer with a platform that exceeds the requirements. This will enable them to reuse their solutions for more product generations, allowing them to invest their valuable R&D resources in other areas. Number two, the efficiency savings has real value to the end consumer. If a person has several pieces of equipment like this in their home, and these items spend an appreciable amount of time in standby conditions, over time, they can see real savings in their utility bills. If you want more information about this controller and its potential to improve the performance of your LLC converter, you can click one of the links down in the description. I'd also like to point you to my blog, which is linked below. In this blog, I'll spend some more time looking at this new controller and discuss some of the features inside the part that make improvements like this possible. I really want to hear your thoughts on this topic. Please take a minute and go down to the comments section. Specifically, I'd like to know, what are your biggest challenges when designing an LLC converter? And what are the most important features you look for in a control IC?